Whenever we talk about solutes in a solution, we should be aware of certain terms. These include molarity of a solution, osmolarity of a solution, and normality of a solution. So what is molarity? Molarity is the number of moles in 1 liter of the solution, where 1 mole is equal to the gram molecular weight of the substance. Okay. So what is molarity? 1 mole in 1 liter. And what is 1 mole? 1 mole is the gram molecular weight of the substance. So say suppose we have taken an example of 0.9% NaCl solution. 0.9% means 0.9 gram of the solution is dissolved in 100 ml. Okay, percent is 100, right? So 0.9 gram is dissolved in 100 ml, or in liters if we consider it is 9 gram per liter, because we are talking in how much moles is dissolved in 1 liter. Okay, so that's why we have to convert it into liters. So 0.9% NaCl means 9 gram of the NaCl is dissolved in 1 liter. So what is the gram molecular weight of NaCl? NaCl gram molecular weight is 23, which is the atomic weight of sodium, and 35.5 you add into that. 35.5 is the atomic weight of chlorine. So we add and we get 58.5 grams. That is the gram molecular weight. When 58.5 grams is dissolved in 1 liter, it is a solution of 1 molarity. Okay, 1 moles dissolved in 1 liter. So if 58.5 grams is 1 mole, okay, 58.5 grams is 1 mole, then how much is 9 grams? Simply 9 divided by 58.5 we have to do. So we will get 0.154 moles. Okay, so you see, just by knowing how much amount of NaCl is dissolved in how much volume, we can calculate the number of moles, right? Now to calculate how many osmoles are derived. Osmoles is the number of dissociated particles. Okay, so we just multiply the moles with the number of the dissociated particles. So when we are talking about NaCl, it dissociates into sodium and chloride. So one NaCl mole gives rise to one sodium ion and one chloride ion. So we can say it gives rise to 2 osmoles. Just multiply it with the number of dissociated ions. Okay. So if we have to calculate the osmoles, multiply the moles with the number of the ions. So just multiply it with 2, you will get 0.308 osmoles per liter. And if we want to calculate normality, normality is equivalent weight, gram equivalent weight. See, here molarity was gram molecular weight. Okay, this is equivalent weight of the substance. And how we calculate equivalent weight? It is molecular weight divided by the valency. For NaCl, there is one positive ion and one negative ion. So we take valency as 1. If there is another substance, say suppose H2SO4, we have 2 hydrogen ions. Okay, that is 2 positive ions, and charge of SO4 is 2-. So we have the valency of 2. In case of NaCl, valency is 1. So we divide the molecular weight with the valency and we get the equivalent weight. So in this case, equivalent weight is same as that of the molecular weight, that is 58.5 gram. So for NaCl, 1 mole is equal to 1 normality. But for H2SO4, it will be different. For H2SO4, valency is 2. So we calculate the molecular weight, divide by 2. That is the equivalent weight, which will be half of the molarity, right? So 1 mole is equal to 2 normality. 1 molarity is equal to twice 2 normality, since equivalent weight is only half, right? So if we want to get a 1 normal solution of H2SO4, we mix half of the molecular weight of the solute in 1 liter of the solution, right? So hope you understood the concept between molarity, osmolarity, and normality. So moving on to the next concept, that is the concept of osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is the pressure exerted by solutes in a solution, and it is calculated by this equation, pi is equal to nRT divided by V. Okay, and in this equation, R is the gas constant, T is the absolute temperature. So these are constants. Suppose if we consider T also as constant, then you see the osmotic pressure pi is determined by the concentration, that is the number of osmoles. N is the number of the dissociated particles. So that is the concentration of the osmoles in a solution. Okay. Now 1 milliosmoles exerts a pressure of 19.3 millimeter mercury. Till now we saw 0.9% solution is creating 0.308 osmoles, not milliosmoles, osmoles. So to convert it into milliosmoles, you multiply it with 1000, you will get 308 milliosmoles. So if 1 milliosmole exerts a osmotic pressure of 19.3 millimeter mercury, then 308 milliosmoles will exert a pressure of 19.3 into 308 is equal to 5944 millimeter mercury. Okay, so this is the simplified, you can remember just by knowing this value N by V. We have to calculate RT is constant. Okay, so that's why with that constant it has been created. Now sometimes we have to put a correction factor known as the osmotic coefficient. Because see, for NaCl we are telling that it dissociates into sodium ions and chloride ions, that is two particles. But there is some interaction effect in the particles. It's not that all the ions are in the dissociated forms. Some of them are in associated forms also, right? In an ideal solution, each NaCl molecule is going to give one sodium and one chloride ion. But there is also interaction in non-ideal solution. So for that, we have to put a correction factor. For NaCl solution, there is a correction factor of 0.93. So you multiply it by that and you will get the correct osmotic pressure, right? Moving on to the next concept of osmolality versus osmolarity, right? So till now, we are talking about osmolarity. Osmolarity is osmoles per liter of solution. Osmolality is osmoles per kg of solvent, okay, not solution, solvent. Solution is basically mixture of solvent plus solute, okay, and here osmolality is osmoles per kg of solvent, okay. So osmoles per liter of solution is affected by volume and various solute concentration. Please remember, because what is solution? Solute plus solvent. So depending on the solute concentration, this volume of the solution is going to be different. So this is affected by volume of various solutes and also the temperature, but osmolality is not affected. So this is ideal to measure, but in books you will see both, because for practical purposes they are considered to be same. Now there are two ways to determine osmolarity, that is depression of freezing point of the solution. Actually 1 moles per liter causes a depression of 1 osmoles, I should write. 1 osmoles per liter causes a depression of freezing point by 1.86 degrees Celsius. And for body, the solutes are in the concentration of milliosmoles, okay, milliosmoles. So that causes a depression of freezing point of, you divide this by 1000, it will be 0.00186 degrees Celsius. Okay, so 1 milliosmoles per liter causes a depression of freezing point of this much. So by determining how much is the depression in the freezing point of the solution, we can determine that how much milliosmoles are there, and hence we can determine the osmolarity. Second thing is by indirect measurement, that is we measure the concentration of sodium ions, glucose ions and also blood urea nitrogen, okay, and then we use this equation where twice of sodium ion concentration, because chloride is also there, right? So instead of measuring chloride separately, we just multiply sodium ion concentration with 2 in milliequivalents per liter, then plus 0.055 glucose in milligram per deciliter. It is not in millimoles or milliosmoles, it is milligram per deciliter. So we are adding a factor of 0.055 so that to convert it into millimoles. For glucose, it is not dissociating. So millimoles will be equal to milliosmoles. Okay, so 0.055 multiplied by glucose concentration in milligram per deciliter. Then similarly, 0.36 multiplied by blood urea nitrogen in milligram per deciliter. So units you have to be careful. If it is given in milliosmoles, then you should directly use it. But here the concentration is in milligram per deciliter, so you multiply by these factors. Okay, so this will also give you osmolarity. Now suppose you determine the osmolarity by these two methods, both the methods you determine, and you find some difference. What you find that the osmolarity determined by this freezing point method is more than that determined by equation method. That means apart from these solutes, that is apart from sodium glucose BUN, other solutes are also present in the solution. That is why there is depression of the freezing point. So it may be due to presence of other solutes, for example ethanol, methanol, mannitol, ethylene glycol, etc. Okay, so that was about the moles, osmoles, molarity, osmolarity and normality of the solution. I made it very simple how to calculate gram molecular weight, okay, molarity, then number of dissociated particles, multiply with the moles, you will get the osmolarity, and normality is the equivalent weight, that is gram molecular weight divided by the valency will give you normality.